Good afternoon. I am MG Kulkarni. I am director of CB Current Consultants Private Limited. I will be covering briefly a topic of recent development in bridge construction and maintenance. So we have just now heard Mr. Deepak Jodhavar, who has given a brief idea about the road projects, highway projects. Now I will be touching bridge projects. First of all, I would like to mention here, this company, C.V. Kant Consultants Private Limited, was founded by Dr. C.V. Kant, a former chairman of our company. He was one of the big names in the bridge rehabilitation and bridge designs in India. He was a member of many Indian Roads Congress committees for bridge designs. I dedicate this presentation to Dr. Kant. First of all, I start with bridge. A bridge in earlier days was supposed to be a construction for crossing a natural river or a stream. Those are bridges. I will just mention here, Ram Setu was supposed to be the first bridge constructed in earlier days for taking all the Vanar Sena and Prabhu Ram Krishna, Prabhu Ram and all their colleagues to fight with Ravana. So I mentioned this was the first bridge we know ever constructed on this planet. Then comes, these are some bridges constructed in far east, that is Cherrapunji. These are man-made bridges constructed from roots and branches of various trees. Nowadays also, the people living there are using these type of bridges. So that is a brief about this. What bridge is which gives access to the road users to cross a natural barriers or nowadays artificial barriers. A road becomes a sanmarg when we construct a bridge across it. So this is sanmarga setunapata. That is, an ordinary road becomes a good road when bridges are built and encourages us to follow the righteous path in life. That is the sanmarga. History of bridges. Brief history. Rameshwar Setu was the first bridge. Then in Bhopal, there is one Kamla Park Bund. That was constructed in 11th century. Kul Pukta, that is also Bund Kam Bridge, constructed in 1775. Then a bridge near Bhuvaneshwar, Calcutta, that was constructed in 11th century. Still it is in use. There are masonry brick bridges, brick bridges constructed in earlier days. There are mainly two types of bridges constructed earlier. Some of them are corbel bridges, some of them are arch bridges. So these were two peculiar types available those days for construction of bridges. First is corbel bridge. This is a typical type of corbel bridge where one stone is kept on top of other stone just protruding outside and then a big stone on top of that. This is known as a corbelling. And this arch form asked from came a very in the letter say when arches were constructed for various structures like temples and bridges as well. This is one bridge constructed in 11th century. This is a typical corbel bridge, Atharvana bridge near Bhuvaneshwar. When there was a annual session of Indian Roads Congress at Bhuvaneshwar, we visited this bridge and we took some photographs. So this is a typical corbel type of bridge constructed in 11th century and still serving. So these are the corbels and the tombstone. Here is some information regarding that. The bridge is spread over 85 meters, breadth is 11 meters. There are 17 to 16 feet across. There are certain arches provided to cross the stream. These are typical arch bridges constructed some 300 years ago. This is a typical bridge near Gore, Murena. In these bridges, they had a concept of creating a pleasant structure as a bridge. They have not constructed only arches. There are some bridges, but these are some typical bridges where they have constructed these minar type of structures for this particular bridge. This is a bridge constructed in Pune. Now we call this as a Shivaji Bridge. Earlier it was called as a Lion Bridge. This is just near Pune Corporation building in front of Shalimar Wada. So this shows a typical construction methodology of constructing arches. How the arch were constructed? There used to be a formwork like this in timber, and then the stones were dressed and kept on the arch. The another method was they used to construct a round shape or arch shape mud, a solid mass. On top of it, they used to place the stones and construct arch. And after the construction, they used to remove the mud which was placed for supporting the arch. These are few arches, arch bridges in Pune. This is a typical arch bridge across near Harris Bridge. This was strengthened by putting another arch of concrete and constructing additional pier across the for supporting these arches. This is a very typical arch bridge. This is a skew arch bridge constructed on a road from Kopargaon to Manmad. Therefore, I have taken some photographs. These are a few photographs. The stream is crossing in this direction and the road is like this. But the arch is constructed to support the road. This is one bridge in Andhra Pradesh. This is arch bridge constructed in brick. I just go through some pictures of arch bridges. This is a stone arch bridge. These are stone arch bridges. This is a bridge across Kalewadi River. Unfortunately, or fortunately we can say, because of construction of another dam and bridge, now this bridge is in submergence of Vaidarna backwater. This is a bridge near Manmad. This is a typical bowstring bridge. This also acts as the structural thing is, it is like a arch only. These are typical bridges constructed in India, particularly by Gamel India. These are called the balance cantilever bridges. This is a typical example of balance cantilever bridges. This is a boring bridge in Goa. The methodology of construction of these bridges were construct a pier and then construct a segment by segment on both sides till this a central portion. This is a similar type of bridge across Narmada at Jadeshwar. These are a few examples of recently built bridges across the globe. This is a bridge, we can say a suspension bridge in China. This is a bridge, Hangzhou Bay Bridge. This is a 36 kilometer long bridge constructed in China. Because of construction of this bridge, a distance of around 120 kilometers was shortened. This is another bridge, Xiaomin Bridge. The span length is 1.54 kilometers. Main span is 1.65 kilometers, which is a suspension type of a bridge. These are few photographs. We can see the diameter of a cable which is passing on the bridge to support the deck. This is a typical inspection gallery provided for inspection of the decks provided for the bridge. This is a Jintan Bridge. This is Lupu Bridge in Shanghai. This is the longest arch bridge in the world. So these are typical examples of arch bridges. This is the actual photograph when we visited that place. This is a basket bridge constructed in PCMC. This is also a unique structure, a unique example of steel structure. Then Bandra Worli Seri is also one of the examples of the new technology of bridges. These are a few photographs. This is open spandrel type bridge constructed by PWD Govt of Maharashtra. These are old bridges. I will go through the pictures. These are arch bridges constructed in old days. Now, I touch upon the main aspect of bridge inspection, repair methodology, diagnosis, repair methodology and rehabilitation of old bridges, masonry arch bridges. Masonry arch bridges and all other bridges are biggest asset of our country and our state as well. So there are certain aspects which we should consider while carrying out this. First step is visual inspection. In earlier days, when we have any ailment, we go to doctors, then they have a method of checking your pulse and make a diagnosis of your ailment. So in the similar way, this is a visual inspection method of assessment of destruction, distresses in the structure, and the further is a non-destructive testing method. Nowadays we can have some non-destructive testing facilities which will also be covered in this. Then another method is structural health monitoring. We can install certain sensors on the old and new bridges which can measure the vital parameters like deflection, then displacement because of the heat, and that can be measured and recorded for further analysis of those data. Then data analysis and reporting and design for repair need as needed. First stage is structural assessment. In structural assessment, we just go through the various components for masonry arch bridges. Like this is a foundation, pier, this is arch, the inner side is called intrados, the outer side is called extrados. Then this is a wall-type structure which is constructed, is called spandrel, then parapet. There is a fill between these two spandrels. Then springing level is the level from where the arch starts. Then there are waterproofing layers which acts to stop the water percolating in the arch. These are the terminologies: arch, barrel, extrados, intrados, pointing, score, cube, spandrel, framing. Why we should carry out the inspection and which components need to be inspected during the inspection. The first point is erosion of foundation due to scoring and dredging of sand from riverbed. In river bridges, as the stream flows, because of the water, a scoring happens, and because of scoring, there are many defects get introduced in the bridge, like foundation gets dislodged. Sometimes because of erosion, the supporting strata get eroded. Sometimes the stones which are used for construction of bridges, those are also get eroded because of the water current. Nowadays, there are another example because of